Good evening. Today is March 25, 2017, and this is the little room of yours truly, Arthur Denchfield. ArthurDenchfield.9 on Facebook, also known as Arcturus Rex on Twitter and Facebook and YouTube. Arthur Denchfield on YouTube. In front of us on this 25th of March, 2017, is a statue of Our Lady Fatima. And today is the feast day of the Holy Annunciation, the Annunciation of St. Gabriel the Archangel to Our Lady, and the Incarnation of the Eternal Word when she said yes. And we thank Our Lady for saying yes, because her yes made our redemption possible. And I've gone through all these pictures and statues before, but I'll do it again real quickly. Here's the Holy Face from the Holy Trial of Turin from the Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior, at the top. And then over to the right is the International Biblical Version Statue of Our Lady Fatima. Picture taken in 1973 in Sao Paulo, Brazil. And that statue went miraculously to New Orleans in 1972. We've talked about it before. And then, of course, way over to the left, St. Michael the Archangel with his sword unsheathed, ready for the word, ready to take action against the world. He's just waiting for the Lord to give him the word. And then, of course, the golden lion rampant is not only the lion of the tribe of Judah, King of Kings, Lord of Lords, our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, but it's also the symbol of the autonomous societies for the defense of tradition, family, and property, known as TFP, an anti-communist civic organization of Catholic inspiration. And then Our Lady of Fatima at her feet are a little flower and a color. Black and white photo of St. Charbel, patron saint of Lebanon, leaning on a statue of St. Martin de Porres, whose name I took the name St. Martin for my confirmation name way back May 1st, 1959, Holy Innocents Catholic Church in Pleasantville, New York. And then, of course, the globe, you have the globe, the Holy Cross is over the land of the Holy Cross, which is Brazil, the land of my birth, and we've talked about that before. And, of course, we have repent. Repent, for the kingdom of God is at hand, and we have to be very, very careful about what's happening nowadays in the church and also in the world and the nations. We have to pray the rosary daily. And way over to the right is the Sacred Heart of Jesus above, the degree, Notre Dame du Lac University degree of my dad. We've talked about that before. And then the eagle is the symbol of America. It's the symbol of St. John the Evangelist. The symbol of St. Vincent Ferrer, and then the four boys are the four boys from Brazil, the living creatures of Ezekiel. You can see the significance of that on ArthurDenchfield.9 and Facebook, and we've talked about that before. And that's our book on planet Earth and the asteroid possibly coming by, or Planet X hitting it sooner than later. We've talked about that too. I'm going to go over to the other side now briefly and speak to you some words about this anniversary. But first, there's a Holy Roman Emperor Charlemagne over there on top of our total gym. And we take this opportunity to thank Chuck Norris and Christy Brinkley for persuading us to get that some years ago. It's a great fitness machine, and we highly recommend it to all who want to not only lose weight but stay strong and so on and so forth. And so let me go over to the other side and speak to you briefly about some things. Okay. Today is the 45th anniversary. Today is the 45th anniversary of our consecration to the Blessed Virgin Mary according to the True Devotion Treatise of St. Louis de Montfort. And the consecration took place right over here where this picture was taken, March 25, 1972, in the Reign of Mary Chamber and the Reign of Mary Seat, Brazilian Society for the Defense of Tradition, Family, and Property, in the presence of Plinio, Correa, Oliveira, and also the founder of the Brazilian TFP, and also in the presence of two Imperial Royal Highnesses, both born in France, His Royal Imperial Highness Prince Louis de Orléans-Braganza and his younger brother, Prince Bertrand de Orléans-Braganza. And We were thinking about some things recently, but we never did finish what we said to you before about the 3 days of darkness. We feel that part of that 3 days of darkness, besides the volcanoes that will be exploding and all kinds of other things like that, will be these UFOs make themselves visible, and then they will block the sun because they are so plentiful out in the, but they cloak themselves in invisibility. And the only way that you can tell that they're out there is if you're watching them through an infrared lens or night vision goggles. We highly recommend Generation 3 or Generation 4 night vision goggles. And those of you who can afford, get the best, because then you'll be able to see what the Vatican telescope at Mount Graham, Arizona sees on a daily basis when they look through that huge, powerful telescope of theirs. They see all of the UFOs in the air. And as I've said before, UFOs are demons from hell. They come from the waters, they come from the oceans, they come from water, and they also come from volcanoes. They dive into volcanoes and they come out of volcanoes, active volcanoes. There are videos about that on YouTube, but we're not supposed to know about that. We're supposed to understand, those of us who are given some clues, that these are so-called extraterrestrials from a smarter planet way out there in a galaxy or another galaxy, and maybe they heard the signal that was sent out to outer space, and they're coming to check us out. That's always a possibility, but we're inclined to believe that these are not extraterrestrials, but they're intraterrestrials. They're demons who have the capability of making extraordinary things happen, magic. They're behind all the magic tricks that you see some of these hugely popular magicians like Chris Angel and Cyril from Japan and a number of others. They get demonic help, and that's been admitted to, they have admitted to this, and it's these demons in the guise of these entities, grays and so on, little people, green men, whatever, they use these anti-gravity machines that defy the laws of physics and are causing a lot of consternation for a lot of people who see them, and a lot of people are seeing them and recording them with their smartphones, and there are videos on YouTube that show, for example, on the Mojave Desert, some Marines were out in the Mojave Desert, and all of a sudden they saw this UFO in the sky, and they headed for the hills to take cover. And then they came out of cover, and they saw a UFO. The UFO they'd seen in the sky apparently had crashed below them in the desert. And all kinds of things like this, proof that these entities, they not only do exist, but they are very, very numerous, leading us to believe that perhaps there's some kind of an invasion being planned on planet Earth. Something right out of science fiction. But you're not supposed to know about this. You're kept in the dark, not only by the government, but you're kept in the dark by the Vatican about what they have observed and found through the infrared, very powerful telescope they have there at Mount Graham. And we say that's very sad, and it's quite troubling. Well, the news has come to us that two of the children from Fatima are going to be canonized. That's these two children here. That's Francisco Marto and Jacinta Marto. They, along with Sister Lucia dos Santos, they saw Our Lady of Fatima in six occasions in 1917, and apparently Francis I is going to canonize them during his May 12, May 13 visit to Fatima this year, which is the 100th anniversary of Our Lady of Fatima. And we find it's quite ironic that Francis I will be the eighth pope who disobeyed Our Lady of Fatima. Disobeyed this request right here. This is a June 13, 1929 apparition of the Most Holy Trinity, Father, Holy Spirit, and Jesus on the cross, Mother Mary, to a Catholic nun, asking that the Holy Father in union with all bishops in the world, consecrate Russia to the Immaculate Heart of Mary. And that should have been done in 1930, and that would have prevented the deaths of over 2.5 billion people unnecessarily. 2.5 billion people, with a B, have died because of the disobedience of 8 popes, including Francis, whose orthodoxy is in question because of Amoris Laetitia, a heretical document that he refuses to answer the dubia of 4 cardinals for and all that. And we claim, we point out a teaching of the church written by St. Robert Bellarmine, Jesuit, doctor of the church, born in 1542, who said that it was possible for a pope to enter into heresy. When he did, he automatically excommunicated himself. And so, since Francis I has refused to answer the dubia of Cardinal Burke and some other cardinals who've asked him for clarification in writing of his position on the Amoris Laetitia, where communion is being given to married, remarried, divorced people who continue their sinful ways and lives, but decide, according to their conscience, that it's okay to receive Holy Communion. That's outrageous, that's heretical, that's wrong, that's not Catholic doctrine, and yet that's something that has got to be addressed. We thank Our Lady. It was on this day in 1972 that Mr. Tim Allen Reese from San Pedro, California, and yours truly, Arthur Layton Denchfield III, Coral Gables, Florida, we made the consecration to Our Lady according to this True Devotion Treatise of St. Louis de Montfort, which we prepared for 40 days in Sao Paulo, Brazil. And we thank you, Blessed Mother. We thank you for helping us for the many benefits, blessings, and graces that we've received in these last 45 years. And we take this occasion to publicly tell you how much we love you and how sorry we are for all the times that we've disappointed you and disappointed Jesus, especially through sins of our past that are inexcusable. But I'm a son of Adam, and I'm not proud of some of the things that have happened. I'm trying, with God's grace, to accomplish my mission, and I ask Almighty God, through your intercession, for permission to join St. Michael the Archangel as soon as I check out of the world, that and do my time in purgatory for the sins of my youth, that I may be a sidekick to St. Michael the Archangel and go around meeting out God's holy justice all over the world until the end of time. And then, when time comes to an end, I ask for a singular privilege, and that is to reside inside of thy Immaculate Heart, if that's at all possible, in heaven. Meanwhile, we thank you, Blessed Mother, for the many, many graces that you have obtained from God for billions and billions of people through the ages, especially as Our Lady Fatima, and we take this opportunity to tell you how sorry we are that the Holy Fathers, from Pius XI to Francis I, have disobeyed God's request. And here is this is Father Nicholas Gruner, Father Nicholas Gruner of the Fatima Crusader. He died last year, and he worked tirelessly for the consecration of Russia to the Immaculate Heart of Mary by the Holy Father, union with all bishops in the world. And he died of exhaustion, and God just took him. And now we find out that Kathleen A. Keating, who wrote this great book, The Final Warning, Your Survival Guide to the New Millennium. She wrote this book, Kathleen A. Keating. She died at the age of 70 in 1910. And she's made these wonderful videos on YouTube. She was a friend of Father Malachy Martin, who was murdered. He was murdered because he threatened to reveal the names of all the Masons in the Vatican. And he was going to have those names published in Newsweek. And when I saw that announcement that he made, I prayed for him and realized his life was in danger. And sure enough, someone threw him off a building. And now we fear that Kathleen A. Keating was also murdered, just like Andrew Breitbart was murdered. Andrew Breitbart was murdered on the eve of the 2012 elections when he threatened to expose Barack Obama's fraud, the fact that he went to Columbia University as a foreign student under the name of Barry Soratoro, and he threatened to expose that on the media, and then suddenly he had a heart attack, and when the coroner checked on his, did an autopsy on him, that coroner died mysteriously too. And now we're wondering if Kathleen A. Keating has not been a victim of some kind of foul play on the part of some very sinister forces that she has denounced in public on her YouTube videos. And we recommend that you go to YouTube and look for the Kathleen Keating videos, her talk with Art Bell from Coast to Coast. She has a great video on the Antichrist, great video on the Great Monarch, and some great videos on the final warning. The warnings that were given to us by heaven at Garabandal in the 1960s, and of course at Fatima in 1917. And the fact is that the third secret of Fatima has never been fully revealed, and Father Malachy Martin, he has read the secret, and he didn't reveal the secret, but he's intimated what the secret contained, among other things, the apostasy in the Catholic Church, which starts at the top, and also a new form of energy. And he talked about UFOs and the fact that they're looking out in space, expecting something huge to come this way. And we believe the U.S. government knows what it is, but they won't tell us. And the Vatican knows what it is, but they won't tell us, because that telescope on Mount Graham there in Arizona is powerful, and it really sees a lot of things through the infrared lens. And we recommend that you get yourself an infrared lens, night vision, monocular, generation 3 or generation 4 telescope, monocular, binoculars, or goggles, and look into the heavens, not only at night, but also in the daytime. You can see, you can check out UFOs that have the cloak of invisibility. They appeared in infrared settings. And of course, according to Tom Horn's book down there, Exo Vaticana, he visited Mount Graham along with Mr. Putnam and talked to the brilliant scientist Jesuit brother, who works there at the astronomy telescope, MIT graduate with honors, Harvard, this, that, whatever. But he's a Jesuit brother, and they're all looking out in the heavens, and they're expecting something huge to appear or to get closer. And they can see these entities. They see these entities because you can't see them with your naked eye, but you can see them through an infrared telescope. And this Mexican professor on YouTube, he showed how when you use infrared lens on a regular camera, instead of this, just a regular lens, you get to see a lot of things in the sky, even in daytime, that our naked eye does not reveal to us. And this is where I feel that the 3 days of darkness, part of the chastisement, which will be at the very end of the chastisement, which is upon us, is going to be all these UFOs. All of a sudden, they decide, a decision is made for them to lose their invisibility, and they become visible. And they literally block out the sun, along with all the volcanoes, the volcanic ash, and of course, other demons will be floating around, because hell will be totally emptied, and the world will truly be purged in the most horrific terror that mankind will ever have witnessed for 3 days. And you will not even be able to see your hand in front of you during the 3 days of darkness. And the only light that will work is the light of a blessed beeswax candle. And then I have my blessed candles right here, and they can only be lit by matches that are blessed by a priest. So all of you who have batteries, emergency food and all that, I mean, the batteries won't work, electric lights won't work, electricity won't work, and matches won't work, candles won't work, nothing will work except blessed candles, beeswax candles blessed by a Catholic priest, lit by blessed matches. And this was all pointed out by Kathleen A. Keating in her book, The Final Warning. and that's why we recommend that book to you. Again, her websites are down. The Enigma file, I can't find it. All of the things that she had before, they just vanished. And I suspect foul play here. I have yet to come across any of her videos where she said anything during the Obama administration, which makes me very suspicious that maybe his administration had something to do with her demise. That's just an allegation, a speculation, an Andrew Breitbart type situation. And we ask God to have mercy on us, to pray that abortion be made illegal again quickly, because now it appears that this Gorsuch, who's being considered for the Supreme Court, he's not really interested in overturning Roe v. Wade, because he considers that to be settled law. Leave settled law alone. That's outrageous, Justice Gorsuch. The right to life, I mean, that's a basic human right guaranteed by the U.S. government to all citizens. And the right to life is guaranteed by the Ten Commandments that say thou shalt not commit murder, and by the natural law, and the fact that 60 million unborn Americans have been legally murdered through abortion since it was legalized in 1973 is outrageous. And over 2 billion, with a B, have been murdered through abortion throughout the world in the last 30, 40 years, since the early 1970s and before. And in the Nuremberg trials of the Nazis, right after World War II, Nazi officers who had performed abortions were condemned to death for murder. That's outrageous now that that's not a murder anymore in the eyes of the law. And science has proven time and again that life begins at conception. We also wanted to say something else, and that is we followed with interest the prophecies of St. Malachy, that Irish bishop, and apparently Thomas Horn and some other Protestant evangelicals and the like. They have been following these events too, and saying, well, let's see, Benedict XVI is the glory of the olive, and so therefore Francis I, he's the last pope. He must be Peter the Roman or something. And what we say is, go to YouTube and listen to Bishop Williamson. Bishop Williamson's talking about the chastisement and the great monarch, and why the chastisement is inexorably coming our way, and there's nothing you can do about it. I mean, you can delay it a little bit by a virtuous life, praying the rosary and so on, but we have exhausted the mercy of God. I mean, his justice is right around the corner, and it's going to be terrifying. And then there's a prospect of World War III and instability in North Korea and missiles flying all over the place. And that's been talked about when Our Lady Fatima said that various nations would be annihilated and Russia would be used by God to annihilate nations. I mean, if Russia was not consecrated in time. And it has not been consecrated in time. And so the evil of communism that enslaved Russia in 1917 has spread all over. America is a communist country in many respects. We have censorship, we have communist censorship, political correctness gone amok at our universities that protect the Marxist and communist and socialist mentality. Anybody who challenges Marxism at the university level is ostracized and mocked and attacked physically. People who've voted for Donald Trump for president on university campuses are attacked. They're beaten. It's horrible. And there's a terrible racism going on in America, not by whites against blacks, but by blacks against whites. An anti-white racism that is outrageous. And this racism business, I mean, is being used now by Muslim immigrants who accuse Scandinavian girls and German girls of racism if they don't give in to their demands for sexual favors and so on. It's just outrageous. And so we know we're at the end, and we recommend that you see prophecyfilm.com, read the book online, called Liberalism is a Sin. Liberalismisasin.com. Go to prophecyfilm.com. Go to AmericanEastFatima.org. Go to churchmilitant.com. Go to Fatima.org. Father Gruner's work. And as far as the glory of the Gloria Olivae, we like to think that the glory of the olive has to do with a person, who followed the olive. What am I talking about? I'm talking about this. This right here. This is a photograph of Plinio Correa de Oliveira. De Oliveira, of the olive. He's the founder and first president of the Brazilian Society for the Defense of Tradition, Family, Property, and he inspired all the other autonomous societies for the defense of tradition, family, and property, including the American one. And he's written many books, thousands of articles, and he has influenced many thousands, tens of hundreds of thousands of people. And his story can be read and seen at tfp.org, AmericanEastFatima.org, Nobility.org, AmericanKnight.org, and so on and so forth. And we say that the glory of the olive is a follower of de Oliveira, who followed him faithfully through the decades. And who, in my opinion, should be the next pope if God wants a layman to become pope. And I've talked to you about him before in this article here. This is July 22nd, 1972, Miami News article. It shows the picture of Our Lady of Fatima weeping tears in New Orleans on the same page. There's an article here about yours truly, conservative Catholic forms group here, along with my friend Nelson Frigelli. I was born March 6, 1942. He was born March 6, 1943. We were both born in Brazil. But he's the man. If God wants a layman to become pope, Nelson Ribeiro Frigelli should be the next pope. And hopefully he would take the name Pius XIII and bring the church back to some kind of sanity. Because the church now is riddled with apostasy. And this apostasy was predicted and prophesied in the third secret of Fatima. And that's probably why John the 23rd did not want to have it published when it was should have been published in 1960. And I was very disappointed. I was in the seminary in 1960 after having graduated from high school, Coral Gables High School in 1960. I entered the seminary. I wanted to become a Catholic priest. I was thinking about being a missionary in India eventually. And then all of a sudden, a statement came out of the Vatican, written by some unknown bureaucrat, anonymous, saying that the third secret of Fatima will never be revealed. It'll go into the archives of history. It was outrageous. Tens of millions of Catholics the world over, hundreds of millions of Catholics were disappointed, and that was the beginning of the tremendously bad, horrendous nightmare that came about through Vatican Council II. And we ask Almighty God to raise a holy pope that will restore the Catholic Church's greatness from the past and condemn the evils and errors of Vatican Council II. And the way the new pope can do that is by closing Vatican Council I and rendering all of Vatican II null and void with an executive papal order. Can happen. Anyway, we feel that the glory of the olive, that prophecy is still true, and that Benedict XVI does not necessarily fulfill that part of St. Malachy's prophecy of the popes. Let's see what else. We have a canonization taking place. The two children whose pictures you see at the feet of the lion there, that's Jacinta Marto and Francisco Marto. They saw Our Lady Fatima in 1917, and they are going to be canonized by Francis I in May. And this is the 100th anniversary of Our Lady of Fatima. And it's ironic, quite ironic, that be careful here. It's ironic that Father Nicholas Gruner here, Father Nicholas Gruner did all this work with the Fatima Crusader for decades, getting entire continents to pray the rosary to Mary for the consecration of Russia to take place. And God took him from us last year. And there he is. He's talking with the two children in heaven right now. And the irony is that Francis I did not obey God's request. God's June 13, 1929 request that I've talked about time and again right here. The Holy Trinity and the Mother of Jesus appearing to a Catholic nun, asking that Russia be consecrated to the Immaculate Heart of Mary. And it should have been done in 1930. If it had been done in 1930, there would have been no Holodomor. And that's why we have the trident right here. This is a symbol of Ukraine. They lost between